All right. It's been a while since I posted anything on this feed, but it's time to get back to it. And that's mainly what I'm here to talk to you about today is kind of the future of what this is, Spatial Stack. I kind of just start with all where it came from. And if you've followed along, you may have come here from some of the live streams I posted before, and that's kind of where this all started. Or maybe you followed me on one of the different channels, be it YouTube or LinkedIn or any of those different things. But I'm getting this built back up again and kind of wanted to talk to you about the future of what this program is going to be. So really it all started as most things do accidentally with a live stream. And I got access to the ability to do LinkedIn live streams, and I saw that they had those on YouTube and thought, well, maybe it'd be cool to do like a live stream tutorial and kind of kick that off. So if you can go back, I think that most of these are on YouTube. I don't think I posted them on the podcast channels. But I just kind of shared what I've been doing before, some tutorials, some technical things, stuff like that. And it got a lot of response. A lot of people showed up and listened and hopefully learned something from those as well. But a few things I learned going through the course of that. One is that it is tough to do a regular technical tutorial while you're in the midst of doing kind of all the other stuff that you're doing with, you know, work and life and all those different things. So I wanted to continue those, but it also made sense to, hey, there's other people who are interested in kind of hopping on this channel and showing what they're up to as well. So that's what it morphed into from there was, as if you go back and you're seeing this on other channels, this is where other people kind of jumped in and joined and shared some of the things that they're working on across the geospatial world. So that also started to add some different pieces to it. And as I did those, more and more people reached out. And it got to be kind of like there was this whole, you know, I had a whole plan and line of people kind of waiting to join in. So this is all leading up to summer 2024 when I made a big jump in my life. And I moved from Carta to Whereabouts, which has been fantastic. But I needed some time to kind of just get settled there and get my my feet under me and learn all the things I need to learn very quickly to kind of help that organization grow. And it's been a really great journey. I've learned a ton. I've kind of expanded some things of my understanding of what geospatial is cloud native geospatial and the tools we're using and those things, and learned a ton too from a lot of really really smart people. It's an amazing group, and thanks to Mo and Gia, the founders there, and Ben, who's welcomed me on board, and everyone that's kind of been just, you know, kind of helped me get up and running. But now that I've had some time, I kind of wanted to open up this channel again and start to talk about all things geospatial, which is kind of why we find ourselves here. But I also had some time to reflect on what I actually really want this to be. And that's what this is about. That's what I'm going to be talking about. So this is a very kind of direct, you're hearing directly from the source, I guess, in terms of what my plans are for Spatial Stack and as a podcast show, what have you. So the first things that I knew I wanted to do is that I know I wanted this to be video first, which is, maybe you're listening to this and you're seeing this or listening to this on a podcast channel, but there is video attached to this, and most of the podcast channels are adding video, and I think video is a really good medium to do this. So if you're not seeing this there, you're probably seeing this on YouTube, and that's honestly, YouTube's growing, and the more I've seen it evolve and having been a part of that platform, I've seen it evolve kind of into adding podcasts or video podcasts as a core component of what it's doing. I mean, I see that those types of missing content can be really impactful. In fact, I've enjoyed and started listening to or watching, mostly listening to, but sometimes it's nice to see a lot of the podcasts over there. So not just this pure audio thing, but also visual. And frankly, in geospatial, a lot of what we do is visual. So I think it's important to have that component to it as well. So this will be a video first thing. I wanted to really just lead into that and kind of lead with that. And the more I've been doing video and YouTube, I can talk a little bit about what my plans are there as well. This kind of interview concept seemed like an extra one to add to the channel that would add a really good context to tech tutorials or some of the stories that I want to tell using geospatial data. So those are some of the things that you'll see on the YouTube channel. So to view this, you can watch it on any of those channels. I don't think there's a good or a bad one there, but it will be a video first. And that's kind of one thing I've always kind of stuck with from the beginning is I've known that's what I wanted to be the root of my show. So there's a few other things I really wanted to embed in what I'm doing on the Spatial Stack and with what I wanted to share. I wrote them down in my notes app, and I've kind of been sitting on those, but there's three key things that I want to embed in what I'm doing here. And if you haven't, I post a lot on LinkedIn and share those things, and I try to make it as direct from me as possible, but those, you know, it can always get, you lose some of that in writing, even in the blog post to a certain degree, or newsletters. Those things have been there as well. So it's hard to kind of get that direct kind of communication and those ideas across. So one thing I want to do is just be able to directly kind of talk about and explore different ideas and concepts. And this is a great format to do that because you're having conversations. You can't do that in any other medium to really have those kind of direct conversations. And that's one piece. And one thing I want to do is also kind of start to, you know, you could call it one of two things. Either expand the understanding of what we're doing with all of this data, with, you know, the things we're studying about the Earth, be it in GIS, geospatial, Earth observation, anything like that. Sometimes I feel like it can be a little bit of an echo chamber. We're all talking to each other about the same things. And to really grow and make this successful and really take the work we're doing and make it impactful, we have to understand how to do that in areas that maybe aren't using geospatial already and really understand the stories of how that's done. And I want to bring and help bring those stories out there quite a bit. So it's not just talking about the tech, not talking about just Spatial SQL or how to use these tools or anything like that. I really want it to say and help others understand how to take the things that we all know and love and we know can make a really big impact in this world and take them to areas and expand and use them in areas that maybe aren't using them in the way that they should or the way that they could today. And I think that's, if we want to do anything with what we're doing, it's take it and expand it and grow it. So that's one really big goal, is to do that. The next is to find those opportunities. And those opportunities can look like a lot of different things. Could that be finding key opportunities for where geospatial grows as a market, as a practice, and skill sets? How do we collectively advance and grow that and expand it so that we can do more with this? I see so many times different things about posting about the size of the geospatial market. It's this many billions of dollars, and it's going to be this many billions of dollars in the years, you know, in the future. And sometimes it feels like we're slowly inching towards that goal, but how do we really identify where those opportunity areas are? Really drive to get there as fast as possible, but do so in a way that we are all being successful. You know, it's, I think the geospatial community is a remarkable one, I have to say. It's so great being at events and meeting people. I was just at the Geospatial Risk Summit today, and shout out to the organizers, Priscilla and the rest of the team there that did a really great job putting an amazing event together here in New York City. But just, you know, I got to meet people that I have never met before. Frank Romo, old, you know, folks that I met before, Will Cadell and many others, and Aravind from EOWatch. I like, these are folks that I've either interacted with online for a long time or seen, but you know, there's that community there, and it's amazing to see and talk to these people and hear from them. So I love that aspect of it. But at the same time, I want us to better understand and work together collectively. And sometimes that can get lost in the mix of, hey, I'm building this technology, or I'm trying to grow this or expand this. And for all of those people that are just, you know, kind of doing the work, how am I supposed to expand and understand where to grow in my career? Where are those opportunities, and how can I do the things that I want to do? So find the opportunity better, whether that be in your career, your skills, your knowledge, growing a business, new opportunity areas. Where are the areas that need help, and how do you do all of that? I want to find the opportunity. I don't have a way to like say that any better, but broadly, those are the ways I would sum that up. So, you know, if we can reduce the echo chamber, find the opportunity, those are the first two goals that I want to accomplish. And the last one kind of speaks to those two. I want to do better together. I really feel that it's important that we work together to grow and expand this thing that we love so much, right? I think one thing that you can say about the geospatial folks, practitioners, users, whatever you want to call it. It's passionate, right? We love what we do. Like I do all this extra stuff because I really enjoy what I do. Like this is the, I'm lucky. I'm very, very lucky to be able to do this stuff, to do the thing that I went to school for, that I've discovered at a young age that I actually really enjoy. Go out there and do it every single day and then talk about it some more. That's a very lucky thing, you know, and I feel lucky to do that. And I think many people do as well. So how do we help each other understand these things and grow and expand? So they're very like lofty, high level goals. So, you know, how does that actually translate into what you might be hearing on this podcast and what you might be listening to or watching, as I've so said it earlier? So let's get into that. What's my plan for the actual things that are going to be on this feed? So I didn't want this to be kind of a type of show where you get the same thing that's consistently coming through. I've listened to a lot of podcasts. I know ones that are like, you kind of know what you're getting every week. There's a different theme. Some things are there that are, you know, going to be, I'm only going to listen. And some things I'm like, well, if I skip a few, that's okay. You know, and then I might find myself rewinding back towards that. I don't want it. I want it to be a little bit more dynamic than that. So at least for the short term, my plan is to have three different types of content that are going to be on this feed. One is things like this. I get to write and post a lot of different stuff, like on LinkedIn, on my newsletter. If you haven't subscribed to my newsletter, I go into things deeper than I do on LinkedIn and try to expand upon them. So if you haven't checked that out, go ahead and do that. It's in the, I guess you call it the show notes. So check out the show notes, if you will, and you can sign up for the newsletter there. But I want to actually be able to tell you to some of those points too. So if you do read these things or want to talk about them, sometimes it's hard to have those conversations in the comments on LinkedIn. I do my best to kind of respond, especially to some of the deeper ones that are there. So, you know, I try to do that and have a conversation. It's always tricky to like manage that because you might not come across exactly the way you want. But I'd like to take some of those topics and do very short versions of that, maybe, you know, 5 minutes or 10 minutes talking about those things. That's one thing that I want to be able to do, is talk about those types of things and expand upon them and use this as a platform to do that, be it whatever it may be, technical. Maybe it's talking about, you know, technical tools and languages. Maybe it's talking about how to expand and grow your skills or whatever that might be. I want to use this as a space to just kind of openly discuss that, because I think podcasting is a very good medium to do that. You can't really, hide behind your words as you know, and it forces you to kind of get out and talk about it a little bit more. So that's one way I want to do that. So I'm hoping those can do that in some short form pieces that you don't have to, you know, oh man, it's another hour long episode I have to listen to. There can be some, you know, challenges with that. So that's number one. Number two is that I was approached by someone who I'm really excited to be partnering with. His name is Mina Nada. He's based out of in Los Angeles, and he's already had kind of a very incredible career. And he reached out to me because he comes from a field that I don't work enough in and I need to learn about, frankly, and I want to learn more how to partner those things together. So Mina and I have been working on some content from a newsletter perspective, talking about something he is very knowledgeable in, which is Earth observation and using that type of data to understand lots of different things about our world. I know the data side, I know a lot of these different things, but my knowledge only goes so far, right? I, you know, in full transparency, you know, I have a degree in geography and I've picked up technical skills and languages over the course of my career, right? And that's kind of where I find myself. I know how to work with data, and I can say that with confidence, right? That's kind of my kind of secret sauce. But I lack in many times some of the scientific knowledge around these different things, you know, Earth observation. Even while I can do machine learning, I'm not a PhD, or I've not gone to grad school to understand these things. So having someone like him that can kind of bring that extra expertise in terms of talking about, you know, these phenomena and frankly imagery and raster data and how to use it and how to look at it as an extra element, you know, that I can't bring forward. Like I know how to move data around and connect to it and those different things. That's great. But I want to add some extra voices around that topic to help me understand it. So Mina has been writing some different content, and I have been sharing that on the newsletter as well as posting that on LinkedIn. So once again, if you haven't signed up for the newsletter, that's where you'll get all this stuff as it comes out. It'll be published on my blog as well. So if you want to check out my website, forrest.nyc, two R's, which I always have to say, but you can check that out there. So they'll be posted there as well. But I also want to take the opportunity to do the same thing, to have a conversation about the topic a little bit more directly and maybe break out some different things that we're thinking about that maybe weren't initially there, and we might find some new ideas about them. So the first one we talked about was the Valencia floods. You know, it was obviously a very devastating event. The world's changing very quickly. You know, we're going to be sharing different ones about lots of different topics around what's happening in the earth. And how do we do that? How do we scale that? How do we use that? Those are going to be some of the questions we're answering. So, you know, another kind of like, we'll have a 15 minute or so conversation about these things, talking about the data, what we've, you know, a lot of the work that he's been doing. How does that play into some of the things that I'm curious about, which is, you know, scaling up the data, making it easier to get these insights out, and then delivering them in different kind of industries and verticals and things like that. That's another version of this that'll be coming out. And then that kind of finally leads me into the third component, which is the longer form kind of discussion, conversation, what have you, what you might think of as your more traditional podcast, right? There'll be guests that come in. You know, I'll be talking to them and hearing their perspectives, but I want to have a good, deep conversation and kind of get some interesting perspectives from people about how they see this industry evolving, right? And how we see geospatial being used. Once again, this kind of goes back to breaking the echo chamber. What are the things you're doing that brings this stuff to other places? How are people using it? Or how have you personally done that? How have you taken geospatial and scaled it out in these different places that maybe you haven't necessarily used geospatial before? I think that's been consistently one of the challenges I hear from a lot of people is, you know, we all know this stuff is really good, but why do we have to sell that out to the rest of the world, right? Why is like business intelligence the big, awesome, amazing thing, but we know we're doing all this cool stuff as well? That kind of seems to be one of the trickier parts about what we do is like, hey, this stuff is important and it matters. So I want to hear the stories about how that's done, right? How have you taken that? How have you been successful doing that? Who's using it? And then, you know, really get a good deep view of our industry. You know, I think talking about some of the things that work well as the challenges and having a very honest and open discussion about what that looks like. Those, I don't know what the length is going to look on those as these conversations evolve, but I've had a lot of interest in folks from before who wanted to do this, new folks that have come forward and want to have these discussions as well. So I just want to be, you know, a facilitator of that and have those discussions and hear from different people and share that information. So there's no other, like I said, there's no better way to do that than having a discussion and conversation and using this as a place to do that. So those are the three formats I want to start building upon for now, right? That there could be more in the future, but at least bringing a diversity of different topics, like one where I can kind of riff off these different topics that I've been posting about and share some direct thoughts, but keep short and sweet. Having that conversation about bringing together these worlds of, you know, Earth observation data and satellites and imagery and climate data and data cubes and all this other stuff that's happening there, and how that works into, you know, data and, you know, computing and infrastructure or even code and programming languages. How do we build those two things? And basically I want to get to a place where you're looking at big problems with Mina and seeing how we can better implement them and get them into a better practice for everyone to be able to use. I think that's a really important question. And then comes the long form discussions with some guests I hope you'll be very interested in hearing from. So that's the plan. That's what this will become. I just wanted to kind of share this and at least give you a sense of where I want to take this. As it relates to the other video stuff that I do on YouTube, I want to continue to do a variety of things there, both from trainings, sharing how to use different, you know, tools and technologies, things that I'm learning that I hope will help you in your career. Also explain, kind of help you understand the technology landscape as it's shifting so quickly. I think that's another key piece that's there as well. But I've also added some new pieces where I actually want to try and once again break down the echo chamber a bit. You know, I know a lot of the folks that subscribe and watch my videos are very focused in on the things that I'm focused about, the technology and things like that. But I realize that there's a bigger view here of saying, how do we take the work that we're doing, the technology we're building, all this different stuff, and expose it to a wider audience? And that's what I'm doing with a lot of the other videos. So you may have seen that I had two videos that I started with, one about New York congestion pricing, another one about the LA fires. There's maps, there's geospatial involved, don't get me wrong, but I want to take those and make interesting stories out of them too. Like my personal interest, when I look at like what I'm watching on YouTube, I'm watching a lot of people talk about history, places, things like that, general geography topics, but there's a lot of things that come back to maps too. There's some great channels that if you are curious, let me know and I can show you some of my favorites. But the more I see like what, you know, what can really drive and spark interest on different topics, it's kind of finding these things that are a little different than what you would normally see, but that expose you to something new. And my hope is that I can help expose that to more people and show them, hey, really what we're doing, what we're working on, and why we think it's pretty cool. And that's the goal with those videos. So there's another kind of level to that too. So that's kind of the big plan. Thanks for sticking with me through this kind of mind rant that I've been kind of keeping in my notes app. And I hope that, yeah, you're here for the ride. So yeah, stick around and I hope to have something interesting here for you.